Welcome back to my channel. Today we're drinking water because we're being super healthy. So this video is going to be talking about every single book that I DNF'd in 2020. And with that, I'm also going to be talking about the few books that I put on pause. I believe there's 6 books I've put on pause as of right now, and some of them are not from 2020. So we're only going to be talking about the ones in 2020. I'll tell you really quickly before we get into the video what that means. So for me, pause means that I got a certain chunk into the book and I wasn't enjoying it, and I was pretty convinced that the fault was mine, not the books. So I put it on pause and I have interest in coming back to the book at a later time. I don't know when, I don't know how. Sometimes I do this because I don't like the format of how I was reading the book and I want a different one. Sometimes it's just I'm being moody. DNF stands for did not finish, and that means that I started a book, I read more than like a chapter approximately into the book, and then I decided this book wasn't for me, I don't want to finish it. We might be here for a hot minute, and I apologize if this video is super duper long, but I will try to get through it really quickly. I'm not going to be going into summaries or in-depth analysis of the books, especially since I can't totally talk about all of them that well, but I will be explaining why I didn't like the book, especially if it seems like something that I should have liked. So let's get started. I'm gonna start with my pause shelf because it is way shorter. So the first one up is The Lies of Locke Lamora by Scott Lynch. I put this on pause because I was listening to the audiobook and the prologue in the audiobook was over an hour long and I just didn't care. So I figured, okay, I'll get past the prologue, right? I'll start the book, and once we get into it, I'll see if I really like it. So the prologue follows this band of orphans, and then the story starts, and it's one of them as an adult, and he's doing con jobs, which I love heist books. I love con jobs. So I should have been 100,000,000% into the book, right? Wrong. Every single character that I met in the first chapter was male. And I was just like not in the mood for it after I had just read a whole entire hour of a prologue about children, which I'm not a fan of children in fantasy for whatever reason. The next one that I put on pause was Malice by John Gwynn. This is a really weird circumstance where I put a book on pause simply because I bought the audiobook from this. I was trying out different alternatives to Audible because I was interested in supporting another group, and then I went through a whole entire existential crisis, and that's not part of this video. So I was trying out this one app, and I don't remember which one it is at this point because I was trying out so many at the time, and I bought Malice. It was like my free book trial or whatever. And so the app would crash every 5 minutes while I was listening to the audiobook, and I couldn't do it. So I was like, okay, cool. I'll just buy it on an app that I have already that I like that I'm going to keep, because I do have a lot of audiobook apps, if you don't know this about me, and I can't find it anywhere else. So I do have a physical copy of it. It's over there on my TBR shelf. I'm planning on getting into it in 2021, but I felt like since I was really into the story and really liking it, that I wanted to give myself enough time because I wasn't sure where I left off in the book. So I want to give myself enough time to forget what I had already read and then restart over just from the beginning. The next book that I put on pause was The Wise Man's Fear by Patrick Rothfuss. So this is the sequel to The Name of the Wind, which I loved. 5 out of 5 stars. I don't think it quite made my favorites list, but it was really good and I really enjoyed it. It has a magical school setting, which is totally up my alley. But when I started book 2, it felt like the same but worse. Like, we were still in this magical school setting, except we had these clues of what was going to be happening because he opened up the story telling us how this one was going to end. So I'm waiting the entire time for that thing to happen. And then there's this one main female that is in book 1, and she's kind of frustrating and infuriating, especially for being the main female lead in a story of mostly men. And in book 2, she just really turned into this whole entire I'm not like other girls, I'm better kind of a thing, and I couldn't do it. I think I could have gotten past it if there had been more plot to it, but I made it a few hours. I think I was like 30%, 25% into the audiobook, and I was just bored out of my mind. So I put it on pause. I'm planning on slowly chipping away at it throughout 2021 until I finish it. I am gonna finish it no matter what. It might take me a really long time. The next one that I put on pause was The Rage of Dragons by Evan Winter, which I often accidentally say Evan Winters. So Apologies, sir. I put this one on pause because I have the physical book. I bought it because I thought I'd be really interested in reading it, which I am. And then I needed to read it with a friend, and so I got the audiobook. And I didn't like the audiobook, honestly. So I should go back to the physical book, right? Except, once again, we're faced with a prologue that is ridiculously long. And the prologue wasn't badly written. I enjoyed it. But it was really heavily focused on this war that was happening. And then chapter one, we're introduced to this boy, this like teenage boy. And it felt like we had gone from this epic adult fantasy into this not so epic YA slice of life fantasy. And I wasn't a huge fan of that weird vibe shift. After that, I have Memories of Ash by Intisar Kanani. So I read and loved Sunbolt, which is the first one in this series, and I talk about it a few different times on my channel. So I bought the sequel and I was going to be reading it. I started it, I made it 60 something pages into it, and the thing that I loved about the first book wasn't in the second one. So the first book really follows this man girl who is orphaned. She's part of a rebel organization who is set out to try and help different people, help whatever they can do, and it's all about her and her relationship with different people in the book. But book two starts out and she gets teleported to this magical desert realm and no one is around for miles. I skimmed a few chapters ahead and it was still just her by herself, and I was like, this isn't what I wanted to read. This isn't the book I wanted to see her relationship with other people, because that's what I loved in book one. Wow, we're already like a few minutes in and we've only covered 5 books. Let's go to the books that I did not finish, and I'll let you know if I ever have any idea if I'll return to them or not, because there are a few that are on this list that I'm like iffy on, but I might one day return to them. So I don't distinguish between my DNF shelf of when I DNF'd books. So there's gonna be some on here that I'm gonna probably be like, I don't remember when I DNF'd this, but let's talk about it. First book on that list is, oh, please don't come for me in the comments, Circe by Madeline Miller. This one's really simple for me to explain. I don't like Greek retellings. The next book was Upon a Burning Throne by Ashok K. Banker. And I think I might give this one a second chance someday in the future, but really where my issue came with this book is that it was so longer than it needed to be. It was so slow paced and it felt like nothing was happening, and I just couldn't get into the story because of that. The next one that I DNF'd was Wake of Vultures by Lilla Bowen, and this one was simply because it's a Western, and for whatever reason, I don't like Westerns. I mean, I've read the second half of Mistborn, which really is kind of a Western setting, and I really liked that, but there was just something about the average Western that I cannot get into. After that, I DNF'd The City of Brass by S.A. Chakrabarty, and this is the second time I've DNF'd that book. The first time I was listening to the audiobook and I was getting really confused, so I thought, okay, let's try reading it physically. It took me about a year or so to finally pick up the physical book from my library. I read farther than I got the first time, which is awesome, but unfortunately, I just wasn't into it. So I went online and I read some reviews and I watched some videos about it. And I think that my biggest issue was it just felt kind of, don't come for me, like a YA fantasy, not so much an adult fantasy. And I felt like I knew where the whole entire story was going, even from book one. Like, come on, we're following this random girl who's picked up by a djinn. Of course she's gonna have some magical abilities. Of course she's gonna fall in love with this djinn. I know none of that to be true, to be honest. I don't know how the book ends, but it just felt like to me that's where the story was going, and I've already read that book and I just didn't care to continue. The next one was This Is How You Lose the Time War by, there's two authors, but I can't remember their names right now, so cover will be here. I hated this. I hated the writing format. I don't like letter books. I don't like books where they are letter format, where it is two people or one person writing a letter to another person. How is that interesting? Who's interested in these books? Why do they keep getting written? I'm not understanding it. They're so boring and so slow. I know a lot of people really like this book. It does have a female-female relationship, but like, how can you tell? It's such a confusing story because it takes place across time and different areas, and it's just, if you haven't read it, I can't recommend it, but maybe you'll like it. After that, I DNF'd Mage's Blood by David Hare. I do plan on returning to this one day. I was listening to the audiobook and I was having an issue because I just once again, felt like I totally knew from the beginning what exactly was going to happen, and I wasn't being surprised by anything. Felt like the characters were just kind of tropes of characters that we used to know and love in other fantasy books, and I just couldn't get into it. And weirdly enough, the main character had the same exact name as someone from the, what are you called? The Black Prism series, and it just was like, wait, but he's here, but he's here, but he... It's my boy, but it's not. So I DNF'd that. After that, I started and DNF'd Heart of Thorns by Bree Barton. I didn't like the writing. It felt very debut, very juvenile, very not my taste. After that, I DNF'd The Alchemists of Loom by Elise Kova, simply because I just didn't like it. I think a lot of people will like it. It has pretty decent readings on Goodreads. I have a hard time getting into steampunk, so that's probably my biggest issue. After that, I DNF'd The Unquiet by Michaela Everett. It wasn't for me. It wasn't my type of book. This was before I was really getting into horror as a genre, and so I wasn't sure that I would like it or not going into it, and I tried it for my Reading Like a Virgo video, which is somewhere linked on my channel, and it's just, it was a flop. Not the one for me. I DNF'd Fire and Blood by George R.R. Martin because I was expecting it to be Game of Thrones, and instead it was a history textbook, and a lot of people have that complaint about it anyways, so just read some reviews before you start books, Amanda. Seriously, I wouldn't have this issue if I did that. I DNF'd And the Ocean Was Our Sky by Patrick Ness because, oh my god, I do not care about whales who are sailors who are trying to hunt down a human. Oh boy, did I really hate this book. A lot. I picked it up because it was absolutely beautiful. There's these illustrations on it and everything, and it is so pretty. Then I DNF'd Curse of the Healing Kiss by Mark McClelland, and that is simply because I don't like retellings. I know earlier I said I don't like Greek retellings, but it really comes down to I don't like retellings in general. I'm not a huge fairy tale person. Don't give me your myths or legends. Just let me read a new fantasy that's not based on anything else. Or if it is, let it be super loosely based on it. Don't make it like an exact parallel, or don't make it based off of like one of the main stories I know. I think that the author needed to figure out their writing style a little bit better and work on that before they released this book. And I got an arc of this one, so it could have changed after it was published. I also DNF'd Where She Fell by Caitlin Ward. This is a YA dystopian girl falls down a hole and tries to survive underground for a long time, which I thought would be really cool because it's a survival story, but it was really more about her just meeting these underground society and trying to figure out her place in it, and I don't care. And I was expecting it to be a lot scarier because it's pitched kind of as a horror, and I wasn't creeped out at all by anything. I think some people would get creeped out by it, but I wasn't. Then I DNF'd Shielded by Kaylin Flanders. Didn't know it was a middle grade going into it. Don't really. I've enjoyed middle grades. There's certain ones I read every year, and there are certain ones I really like. This one, the writing wasn't there, so it didn't hold up. Kingsbane by Claire Legrand. Oh boy, this just felt like it lost all of the special pop and circumstance and flair that the first book had. I really loved the mystery behind the first book, and this one, the main character was just such a bitch. I couldn't get behind her. It felt like she was developing in the wrong way, and I was frustrated and infuriated, and every single time she said anything, I was listening to the audiobook, I would zone out. I was so done with her. So I DNF'd, because who the hell cares? I also DNF'd City of Ghosts by Victoria Schwab. I decided for some reason that because I love Schwab, that I was going to read her middle grade series, and that's dumb because I don't like middle grades. I also DNF'd The Madman's Daughter by Megan Shepherd, and that was part of my Virgo reading series too, and it wasn't for me. Ooh, here's a hot take. I DNF'd Skyward by Brandon Sanderson. Eek. Apparently I don't like YA sci-fi. I mean, I should have known that because I'm not a fan of sci-fi to begin with, but like, I love Brandon Sanderson and I love his writing, but there's, the main girl is so, I just wanted to punch her in the face. And I got about 100, 150 pages into this book, and I was like, if I hate the main character so much that every single time she thinks or says anything or breathes, then maybe I should just not read this book. Like, I don't have to read every single book written by an author. I don't have to love every single book that is loved by everyone else. So I DNF'd it. Then I DNF'd House of Dragons by Jessica Clueless, which it felt way too juvenile. They were calling it YA. It felt like middle grade. The first four chapters are the same exact chapter, but told from different perspectives. And it seemed like that was how it was going to be for the rest of the book. And I'm like, the first four chapters took over 50 pages. So I basically read one story and then had to reread it for the next 50 pages. Don't like that. And then I DNF'd If We Were Villains by ML Rio. God, you want to talk about some pretentious snobs? No one cares that much about Shakespeare, my dudes. I'm really sorry if any of these are your favorite books and I'm getting heated over them. I don't mean to insult you or insult the books themselves. I'm just letting you know why I didn't like them. And I think that we can all appreciate that not every book is for every single human being. Then I DNF'd Imagine Me by Tahira Mafi. So I've weirdly been loving this series from the very beginning. It seems like something that I wouldn't be super into because of its heavy romance themes, but for whatever reason, I was there for it and I've been loving it so much. And even the one right before this is the sixth book, and honestly, 5 and 6 and 4 didn't need to be written, but I liked 4 and 5. I thought they were pretty decent. I felt like they were unnecessary, but pretty decent. But book 6 was just Juliet having panic attack after panic attack. And I understand that panic attacks are realistic and people have them back to back. I have them back to back. I understand it's a real thing. But she had already developed out of that sense from book 1, 2, and 3. So book 4 and 5, she was the strong, independent woman, whatever. And then book 6, she went back to how she was. Like, I've read that. Let's move on. Let's get back to, like, her being a badass. Then I DNF'd The Grace of Kings by Ken Liu, which it was a really good book. And I was enjoying myself through most of it. It honestly reminded me of The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. But there were no women in it. There were absolutely no women. There was one woman, and her whole entire role in the book was to marry this man and bear him children. And she didn't even get a POV. And I read online people saying, like, oh, if you continue on after like 70%, there's a woman who's like a soldier and she's great. I don't need to read 70% of a book to get a character I can relate to. And when you have so many men as your main characters and lots of different POVs, I start getting I had a hard time telling them all apart because they were all similar men. They were all the same exact type of man. And I don't need that in my life. So I DNF'd it. Then I DNF'd Saga Volume 3 because I wasn't enjoying myself. I didn't love volume 1 or 2, and they introduced this format in the book in volume 3 where news reporters were going to be interviewing different characters split out throughout the novel, and that's not for me. That's right up there next to letter format. Don't give me interview format. Don't care. Unless it's like really short. Like, I don't mind if you start like a chapter novel and the very beginning of each chapter is like a really short blurb where it's something else, or if it's a letter or whatnot. But I just, I realized I had been hating the whole entire series the entire time I was reading it, and I didn't understand why I was forcing myself to read it when I wasn't enjoying it and there were other things out there for me to enjoy. And then I DNF'd Ashes of the Sun by Django Wexler. I might one day return to this. I was super happy to get an e-arc of this book from Orbit, and I read a good chunk of it, enough that I could write like a little review for people to read for them to understand whether or not they would like this. I think where I really fell short was just the writing. I don't think I'm a fan of Django Wexler's writing style, so I might give it a shot and finish it one day. I really hope to, because it really wasn't a bad story. I liked the world building a lot, but I also know myself, and I know that urban fantasies tend to frustrate me more than like fantasies that aren't urban setting. Oof, here's a big unpopular opinion. I'm gonna need to take a sip to talk about this one. I DNF'd The Dragon Republic by R.F. Kuang. Why, you ask? Why did I DNF this book that I rated the first one to 5 out of 5 stars? Absolutely loved it, made it my favorites of the year, reread twice in 1 year. Well, I read it and then reread it, so I read it twice in 1 year. Because nothing happened. I read 30% of the book and it was just our main girl doing nothing. And I could have like gotten into it, I guess, if we had seen her struggle and her development and like if I could gotten behind it, but it took the parts of the first book that I didn't like and made that the whole focus of the second book. So I DNF'd 10,000 Doors of January by Alex E. Harrow. It read like a historical fiction, not a fantasy. All the Stars and Teeth by Adeline Grace. Really weird sexual energy for a YA book. Like, I think some people would really enjoy this, but I just got such a weird vibe. The Obsidian Tower by Melissa Caruso. I simply couldn't get into it. I read like 100 pages and it just wasn't for me. The Gilded Wolves by Roshani Chosky. Audiobook isn't the way to go for this one. I am planning on one day getting back to this, probably in 2021, without the audiobook, so it should be on my pause shelf. The 100,000 Kingdoms by N.K. Jemisin. Oh boy. How do I say this nicely? It was not the right type of weird for me. That seems pretty nice. Star Daughter by Shveta Thinkrar. It was a contemporary fantasy. I don't like contemporary fantasy. I didn't know that when I went into it. I really need to do my research better. The Shadow Wand by Laurie Forrest. I loved this series. I love book one and two. I felt like they were so good. I felt like they really were such a great take on racism. I know a lot of people have issues with them. I like to believe what the author says and that she was showing a character who develops out of her racism, which is a hard thing to write about, I understand, but I really loved them. Book three, it did this thing that I really hate in series, which is book one and two are following a singular POV. We are following one character. That is all we are doing. And then book three. Okay, well, now we're following multiple POVs. That is a quick way to get me to DNF your books, authors. Just Foundry Side by Robert Jackson Bennett. Physical book wasn't for me. I'm going to try the audiobook sometime. Prince of Thorns by Mark Lawrence. I didn't DNF that this year. How'd that make it on the list? The Killing Moon by N.K. Jemisin. Just couldn't get into it. I really loved the fifth season, so I wanted to try all of her other works. Wasn't for me. Throne of the Five Winds by S.C. Emmett. I didn't like the writing style. It felt like I had to really concentrate on the book. It felt like it was too smart for me. I do think one day I might retry it. The Book of Dragons by Jonathan Strahan, and it's a bunch of short stories, so it's not just by him. I think he like put the short stories together. Don't like short stories. Simple as that. Dune by Frank Herbert. This is the second time I've DNF'd Dune. Let me tell you. I have a lot of strong opinions about why Dune is not a great book, but really what it boils down to is there is a band of female warriors who have prophesied that a savior will one day come and save them. And that savior is a young white man. Mexican Gothic by Silvia Moreno Garcia. I don't like gothic books. Why did I start this? That also goes for Catherine House by Elizabeth Thomas. Don't like gothic stories. I don't know why I started it. I just felt like Catherine House was really dull and boring though, more than anything else. I think one day I might like to try to finish it, but that day is not today. This one I actually genuinely regret, and that is Raybearer by Jordan Ifunko. And the reason why I regret it is because I think it was a really fantastic tale, but once again, I don't think it was for me. I think that having this diversity in fantasy is absolutely amazing, but this story read like a saga. We start out the book where the girl is very young and we would get like a chapter of a year, a chapter would be another year of her life, a chapter would be 4 years later, and I don't like that. I really dislike when books do that. I feel like getting small snippets of people's lives throughout, to me, feels like I'm not really getting a story. I'm getting a history lesson. I was listening to the audio. I think one day I'd like to try to pick it up physically and finish it because I think that this book is really important for a lot of people and a lot of people love it. And I'd like to be able to recommend it to people because even if I dislike it, that doesn't mean that it's a bad book. And just because I DNF'd it doesn't mean that it's a bad book. It just means that it wasn't for me. Over the Woodward Wall by Deborah A. Baker, which is a pseudonym for Seanan McGuire. This one's really simple. I don't like kids' books. It was the like spinoff. It was like the short story, whatever, for Middle Game, which apparently it's going to be a 4-part series. But I tried to read it because I love Middle Game, but this wasn't for me. Still Life with Tornadoes by A.S. King. Oh boy, I talk about this one a lot on my channel. It wasn't weird enough. A.S. King is known as a weird writer, and it felt just kind of like a regular contemporary story with a little bit of magical realism thrown in, and I really hated how pretentious the main character was. Jade War by Fonda Lee. I was in a really weird mood, and I didn't want to continue this long-ass book. That's the only reason. So probably one day I'll finish it. I'm kind of always in a weird-ass mood. Assassin's Apprentice by Robin Hobb. I didn't like how the story was being told. It felt really old, which I understand it is an old book, but it just felt like a fantasy that was written a really long time ago. Zombie Bake Off by Stephen Graham Jones and Growing Up Dead in Texas by Stephen Graham Jones. Zombie Bake Off, I couldn't get into the story. Growing Up Dead in Texas, it's a memoir, but it's a fantasy memoir. It's not a real memoir, but it's written like a memoir, so I don't like memoirs. And then finally, we have The First Sister by Lyndon Lewis, and this is going to be the pettiest reason on this list. The narrator is the same narrator from The Poppy War, and I couldn't get past that. I love when narrators narrate multiple books, but since I was still kind of pissed about the sequel to The Poppy War, I couldn't do it. I know I said at the beginning of this video this was all of the books that I DNF'd. This actually isn't all of the books I DNF'd. Whoa, my God. Holy crap. You just went for a ride and I apologize. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate each and every one of you. I hope I didn't insult any of you. It's not my intention. My intention is just to... This is a way for me to record how I read and to help better introduce other people. If you know you have a similar taste to me, then maybe you know now that these books aren't for you. A lot of them I'd be willing to pick up again because me is the issue. I don't remember how my outro goes, but until next time, I'll talk to you all in the comments. Bye.